It is a special ribbon cutting night here at Daytona State. Meanwhile, the Falcons will welcome in their arch rivals, the Titans of Eastern Florida. NJCAA soccer coming up next. Welcome to Daytona State's College Soccer Stadium. Here in Daytona Beach, we're ready for what should be a fabulous night tonight as the Titans invade this complex to take on Daytona State. The Falcons will be the home team tonight. We are thrilled to have you with us, everybody. I'm Drew Felios alongside Ted Sofiano. It's been an emotional night so far with a special ribbon-cutting ceremony for this magnificent facility. And now it's time for some tremendous football, Ted.
Let's get it on, Drew. I mean, this is obviously a grand night. It's a community night. And we'll talk more about it. I see they're lining up right now for the anthem. But I've got to say that one of the crowning achievements of this administration is certainly how we've come together, not only as a college, but as a community, to bring to you today this incredible field.
Daytona State comes in ranked number 6. Meanwhile, Eastern Florida comes in ranked number 11. The Falcons with one loss on the season. Eastern Florida comes in with two losses.
Yeah, how about that today, Drew? You moved up one in the rankings from 7 to 6. Good to see that kind of gain.
At this time, we ask you to please rise to the plank.
And now we pause for the national anthem. So the Falcons will wear the black tonight. Eastern Florida State College wears the white. And there's Bart Sasnett in his second season leading this young program at Daytona State. And one of the big things on his resume right now, he's had great success against Eastern Florida so far.
You know, and that's not easy to do against a club like this. I mean, they've got gents from all over the world, you know, Drew. I mean, it's not just some of their local talent. They've got gentlemen from Liberia and the UK. I mean, they're stacked.
Certainly an international bunch for Eastern Florida State College. There's Ryan Sandage. He'll get the start again tonight, the center mid sophomore out of Orlando. And there's Oliver 12 Trees, the Englishman, head coach of Eastern Florida. Consensus thought, he is one of the best in the business at this level. What he brings to the game, what he brings to the sideline, just a tremendous head coach, Ted.
Yes, definitely. I mean, he was explaining to me some of his core values. Obviously, academics at the top of it, graduating, but winning was his number two. He also talked about just becoming better people. And lastly, he believes that he has this farm club almost for the pros.
So Eastern Florida State College, 2-1 in conference play on a four-game win streak. Big win over Chivas and Weber International to get to this point. So I'm Drew Felios alongside Ted Sofianos. Sit back, enjoy. Should be a fabulous night of NJCAA soccer. here in this fabulous complex. The stands more full than they have ever been this season. Board of Trustees here, school president also here, Tom Labasso. Will Dunn, our athletic director, part of the ribbon cutting. Saw Miss Hosseini also here. It's just been an amazing night.
You know, to see all these people show up, show out. I mean, we obviously know this is a great complex by being here and witnessing it. But those of you at home, you got to come down and see this complex. It is amazing. And let me say something else. Although our mission, right, it's Daytona State College, Community College, we say state college, but it's really community college. I mean, you look at the people who are here. We really have a community mission when you start thinking about some of the folks and camps and also events that are occurring. So, Drew, I'll hand it over to you for the play-by-play as we begin.
Well, this is a heated rivalry, certainly, between these two great institutions, but it's also a friendly rivalry. Eastern Florida instrumental in helping Daytona State get this great facility right. That was acknowledged in the pregame with Dr. Labasso. So just great to see these two clubs matching up with each other on a night that will certainly go down in history in Falcon Athletics.
Definitely, definitely. It's great to see the Eastern Florida State president also here, again, sharing what they've had for success down south and, you know, helping us a little bit put this together.
So underway, Eastern Florida going right to work as that one taken from the left wing. Be a goal kick coming up for Daytona State. Phil D'Amico, the sophomore, gets the start tonight in net for the Falcons. Transfer from West Florida. We saw him last week and had a couple goals scored on him early in that Thomas University JV match, but came back and he was a wall in the net during the second half, not allowing a goal.
Gave us the jitters for a little bit to start, but he certainly found his oats and did very well as the game progressed. You know, Drew, I'm so glad that you reminded me. I'm so used to seeing the Falcons in white, so I have to kind of reorient myself. We're in the darker color tonight.
Keep in mind, these two teams last played back on September 20th, and it was a 2-1 win for your Daytona State Falcons. This is Craigton Charlton, 7 goals on the season. Certainly one of the stars for Daytona State. Nice pass there by De Leon. And now the cross in, shot off the goalie. The ball in there and taken just to the right of the net. That was nearly the first goal of the match. Daytona State applying the early pressure to Notar Donato, the keeper for Eastern Florida.
They might have come out a little bit lucky there. I mean, that was a little ping pong deflection, and I think Eastern Florida got away with one there.
Eastern Florida's had another solid season, but not nearly as explosive scoring goals as Daytona State has been. 38 goals scored by the Titans coming into tonight. Daytona State, with 2 more games played, has scored 55.
You know, they're balanced, Drew. I mean, they're obviously they have the scoring machine capability. At the same time, excellent defense. You saw it right there.
And right there is where Daytona State is so dangerous in the midfield making plays. Now a pass on the run, and Eastern Florida going to get called for the offsides.
You can tell they got some speed up front, though. We're going to have to be wary of that in our defense.
So we're going to see number 16, Dodomo, for Eastern Florida. Keep an eye on him. He is a tremendous talent. And then also Myers, number 18, a guy that really makes everything go. He is the ultimate sweeper.
Oh, yeah. I was talking to Coach, Coach Oliver about Reese Myers. And he kind of analogized him to Beckenbauer. Those of us who are old enough to know the game remember Franz Beckenbauer from Germany back in the day.
Just underway here, Titans and Falcons, and it goes across the touchline. It'll be a throw-in coming up for Daytona State. So Charlton will throw it in. What a surprise this young man has been for the home team. 30 shots leads the team. Golikowski, who played well last week in that Thomas University match, comes up to throw it in for Daytona State.
You know, and Tomic and Segre seem to have good games as well last time we were together, Drew.
Throw in, headed outside the 18. And now Daytona State has a chance to reset. Trying to tack that left flank now. Neither team has really had a good long possession so far in this match. Here's Golikowski trying to cross it in. Eastern Florida able to keep it out of danger this time. Gonzalez couldn't control it, and Daytona State has it once again. For the moment, taken away by Gonzalez. Well played by the Titans. Now it's Rosary, four yellow cards on the season for the freshman out of Toronto, Canada. And tell you what, Ted, you're absolutely right. You look down the roster of the Titans, and you see literally players from all over the world, making it that much more challenging for Coach 12 Trees to get all of these players to play together, because you got a lot of them growing up with so many different styles of football.
Oh, right? No, that's an excellent comment. You know, some people say, come on, soccer, soccer. No. The English play different than the Germans. And the Caribbean islands, right, you have a different type of play. You look over to South Africa, a different kind of play. So that's an excellent observation, Drew.
A lot of energy early on the field. Just get the sense these players know really how much this match means tonight. Gonzalez trying to save it along the touchline, and it'll be a throw-in coming up for the Titans.
Yeah, I think the winner of this match, Drew, is they're going to move on the standings, no doubt, you know, once they come out again next week.
Owen Torkowski, sophomore out of Melbourne. Over there, you take a look at the fabulous keeper, Phil D'Amico, for Daytona State. Making sure everybody is tightly marked here on this throw-in. It's a good throw-in in the danger zone. Titans just not able to get a good foot on it. Now here comes the speedster, Charlton, the other way. Look at the wheels of Craigton Charlton. The ball deflected, and that one had a shot. But Charlton... Boy, as he is racing downfield, the crowd really got into that run.
I know he's having some second thoughts about whether he should have kept going as strong as he was or passed across the middle, but I think he made the... Oh,
Titans,
no.
The first goal of the match scored, and Eastern Florida gets on the board, the perfect counter. And it's Dodomo who put it through. And how about that celebration to make it 1-0?
Well, I mean, you know, That's the ping pong, the bounces of the game. I mean, DSC had an excellent opportunity. It was a 3-on-1, actually. And as you just stated, Eastern Florida State with a very nice counter. Right wing made a great move to come back onto the inside and just hit the ball down low to the right side of the keeper.
Yeah, how about the keeper, Notar Donato, coming all the way out to be part of that celebration. Still got a lot of football to be played here.
That's Ken. Right. That's right. Don't get too cocky yet. We got a lot of game left.
It's that kind of night, though. Emotions running awfully high. Falcons coming right back. This one's sent out. Going to have a corner kick. First one of the game coming up for Daytona State. And there you take a look at the guy who scored again, Danilo Orsi Dodomo, sophomore forward out of London. And what a talent he brings for Eastern Florida, just showcased it.
I mean, you know, just being calm and collected, pulling the ball back as he faked the shot. The defender did well to respond, but it was just too much of an advantage right there with the one-on-one and the keeper.
Ryan Sandage now, the in-swinger for Daytona State. Puts this one a good spot right near the six, and the heading attempt was just a little bit off. Great idea for the Falcons that time, and it was 16 Kurtanovic who got the start tonight, who was right there.
Right, 16 Kurtanovic. A great header, just a little bit left. Certainly had the trajectory, just not the aim in that particular case.
You know, Ted, the one worry that you have coming into this one for the Falcons is obviously such an emotional pregame ceremony. You see everybody here being a part of it. Sometimes you forget the task at hand. I know the player's very focused, but guarantee you, Eastern Florida banking on the fact that maybe Daytona State's going to not be 100% focused because of so much hype during the pregame. What do you think?
I'm not sure that Coach Sasnett's going to let that happen. You know, I guarantee he had them all geared up. And you know what? It wasn't even a lapse in the back. It was just some better play from that offender. These things happen, and certainly counterattacks are one of the best parts of the game when you're watching soccer, because as we all know, sometimes there's plays usually develop. They come from the back, but in that particular case, it was so quick, and they just happen to outmatch us.
Here's Perez, yep. Loses it right there. The whistle is blown as Rosary came over.
And honestly, he would have gotten away with that, the Eastern Florida State player. It was just that he used his left arm to push out. If you use your shoulder, you'll be fine. But he really pushed, Tomic right off the ball. So good foul, good call for the ref. And, you know, hopefully it stays even, right, for the referees, as they normally do. Impartial.
Just underway here at Daytona State, Drew Felios, Ted Sofianos. And our fabulous crew here at Daytona State College bringing just an awesome match to you tonight. Notar Donato comes out to field this one. Titans going on top, 1-0. Danilo Orsi Dodomo with the first goal for EFSC.
You know, when you have folks like Charlton, O'Sullivan, right, you know that we're not going to be quiet for long. DeLeon. We're not going to be quiet for long. I guarantee they're going to be pushing up. The thing is, though, strategically speaking, you're going to see Eastern Florida now switch up their formation with that one-goal lead.
Send this one ahead. Golikowski playing it on the right flank. Had it taken away, though, and a good job by Eastern Florida in the back that time. Not seeing Joe O'Sullivan get into the action just yet. He's right near the ball right now, number 18 for the Falcons. But if there's one thing that Coach Sasnett said over the past couple weeks that is really shored up for Daytona State, it's been the back line, Ted. He says that, you know, they really suffered after the injury to Rory O'Keefe. Took them a while to really find themselves back there. And right now, everything is clicking in the back.
Exactly, but always a... You know, when you lose a player like that, even for a little while, it kind of takes away from the consistency. There's an errant pass. But I've noticed, though, that it seems that Eastern Florida has brought one extra player to the back. So Coach Oliver knows we're strong offensively, but at the same token, he's playing a little bit to shield that one-goal lead.
Owen Torkowski for Eastern Florida. Ball sent ahead to Rosary. Rosary, a little hesitation, now decides to go. Good tactical skills being shown. Oh, that was a good idea. Ball just a little bit ahead that time, though, and now Daytona State will get possession again.
Yeah, you got some skillful offense there. Great dribbling skills, control skills. A lot of natural ability as well.
Daytona State unbeaten at home so far this fall. Not only one of the highest power teams in the nation, but also one of the most unselfish, 53 assists to go with those 55 goals. That's ninth best in the country. Play it inside the center circle now. George sends it out. And Eastern Florida showing pretty good patience offensively so far in this first half as Lowe, the freshman from Sweden, handles.
If they persist in playing this control game from the back, Coach Sesnett's going to have to put a rudder up there.
Now Falcons applying some pressure. Ball sent back to Notar Donato. And Ted, how do you speed up well, Eastern Florida right now, because clearly they're trying to slow the game down.
This is classic English football, what he's doing, what you know, Coach Oliver is doing. I mean, it's classic English football. I mean, he's pushing everybody up. Goalie's coming up above his 18-yard box, and they're just playing a little bit of keep away. But there are strategies that, of course, Coach Sasnet can apply later on as time goes on. Right now, we're letting them have that game.
Now the Falcons try to attack. Ball cut off, though, and a good job by Eastern Florida. Falcons able to come right back, though, applying some nice pressure. And the ball's going to be awarded to Eastern Florida. Ryan Sandage all over Max Scherer. The pitch is absolutely superb tonight. Look at the surface these two teams are playing on. Looked good last week. Looks even better here on this Tuesday night, doesn't it?
Oh, it's absolutely gorgeous. It's a Bermuda grass.
How about that pass sneaking in? Shot taken and scored.
Oh, my.
The flag does not go up. It's 2-0. Titans add to their lead.
I think we believed we had them offsides. But the ref didn't see it that way.
Eastern Florida has come in and quieted this crowd that packed the stands tonight. So far, it's been all Titans as that goal scored by Lowe. And he scores it in the 15th minute.
Now, although you might feel a little bit down, right, as, you know, the team psychology of it, they've got to come back for an equalizer before half. Can't let it go any more than 2-0. And obviously that'll help tremendously if they can make it 2-1 or 2-2, you know, by halftime. 30 minutes still to play.
Certainly not going to trim the gap in one play. Got to continue to be patient if you're Daytona State.
Yeah, and as you see, they only had a couple of shots on goal, and unfortunately, both of them back of the net.
So the Falcons trying to settle in here, and game number 13 at home.
You know, when you get to this level of play, Drew, you know, you have to. I mean, efficiency is effectiveness. And obviously, if you're 2-for-2 with two shots on goal and you got two in the back of the net, that's going to make things a little bit difficult for our Falcons.
Golikowski goes for the cross. Saw the physical play there as Dixon, a little elbow to the back of Charlton. And there's Trevor Golikowski, the freshman out of West Palm Beach.
Yeah, and I you know, obviously in the penalty box, it might have been more of a shoulder than an elbow, because obviously if he used his hand or grabbed his shirt, would result in the penalty, but the referee thought that was, okay to shoulder him off.
Bryce Notar Donato, 19 saves coming into this match. Had that big one early on. The opening minutes. Craigton Charlton had a gorgeous run about 10 minutes ago, but really that has been all the offense so far for the Falcons. Have not been able to consistently possess here tonight.
Yeah, that's another thing. You get used to each other, right? I mean, this is not the first time these teams have, you know, been at the dance together. And, you know, obviously right now, at this moment, Coach Oliver has got things figured out for, you know, Eastern Florida State.
Keep in mind, in this great series, which is only 5 games old because Daytona State still just a second-year program. Daytona State has won 4 of these showdowns. Eastern Florida has only won 1. So the Titans have come in tonight clearly feeling like it is our time to shine.
Exactly. And I, you know, right now they've got the better, you know, of the first half so far, but, you know, we've still got a lot of time left. We got 45 plus 28. We got, you know, 73 minutes left. And a lot can happen with that kind of time remaining, you know. And if I was, of course, coach on the sidelines, I'd just be encouraging them and, of course, strategically setting them up.
Now it's Rosary. Torkowski touching as well for Eastern Florida.
A lot of control and a lot of possession showed by or displayed by Eastern Florida at this point in time.
Now the Titans start to press just a bit. See if that disrupts the rhythm of Eastern Florida.
You know, the keep away game, I guarantee coach is only going to let it go so far, and then he's going to start flooding them up front, but that's going to be tactically done through various strike times.
Titans send it downfield now. D'Amico comes out, takes care of it, just inside the 18.
You know, and let's not, you know, let's mention that, you know, D'Amico had no chance on both of those goals. I mean, he was positioned correctly. It was just a better shot than where he was positioned.
Charlton let it rip that time. 7 goals on the year. Is this the guy right here, Creighton Charlton, that's got a spark Daytona State right now, Ted?
You know, he just did a really smart thing. He turned and shot because I don't know if he has eyes in the back of the head, but he knew that keeper was out. He was actually trying to pull a floater. He just caught over the ball a little bit, but an excellent idea. Trying to catch the keeper out of position.
Lothar Donato, goal kick for the Titans. Battle of number 6 and number 11 here on this Tuesday night. Going to have so many great matchups in this stadium in years to come. That's what's going to make this rivalry so exciting. This complex now coming into shape. Going to see some fabulous soccer in years to come. And also, special thank you was given out tonight to Embry Riddle as the flag goes up that time. Embry Riddle for allowing Daytona State to have their soccer complex last season while this was being built at it.
Embry Riddle, we went through a hurricane way back in, oh gosh, it was about 03, and Embry Riddle allowed us to use their complex back then and also last year. So we've had an excellent symbiotic relationship with Embry Riddle. They had a complex that got blown down. They were able to use our gymnasium back then. So we've been going back and forth, and it's a good mutual understanding that we have with them, obviously furthering the tenets of education.
Gets loose just outside the box, and that one nearly could have made it 3-0. And I'll tell you what, Dodomo right now causing the Daytona State back line some issues.
Yes, and if you notice, they're only leaving one striker up front. Everybody else has flooded back. They are certainly now, it is obvious, protecting that 2-goal lead. And it's just going to make our job all the harder. A little ticky-tack foul, good call, ref. Ref has been very even, both sides.
Daytona State's got tonight, then just 2 regular season contests left, Broward College and ASA away. And the Falcons just struggle a little bit, Ted, to just possess the ball, get some good possessions in to kind of get everybody flowing. It doesn't seem like the offense is really settled in. You know what I mean? Where they've had good possessions where everybody touches.
Yeah, right now, I mean, I haven't put a clock on it, but possessions certainly for EFS and Daytona right now just struggling a bit to possess the ball, which is going to be more of the case than not right now. Why? Well, the fact is that they're playing back. You know, EFS is playing back right now, and so we have to take our chances. We are not going to play a possession game right now because of the way the score is. And that makes total sense.
Titans now send it ahead and now able to turn it upfield. Eastern Florida continued to apply pressure here. Little flick, and it goes over to D'Amico to take care of it inside the 6.
Have a player down on the far side of the field.
That's Idrisu, who is down for Eastern Florida. Abdul Idrisu, freshman midfielder out of Ghana. A little shaken up. Hopefully he is okay.
Yeah, I didn't see what quite happened there.
Training staff comes over to have a look. Daytona State, been busy over the past week. Big win over Thomas University JV, in which they trailed 2-1. And that game, that was last Wednesday, then took care of Broward on Friday. Tough match, 2-1. And then a victory over Weber International, 6-1 on Sunday. And there's a good sign as Idrisu helped up off the field.
Yeah, yeah, he's up and moving. Doesn't even look like he's limping at this point, so that's good. You know, Drew, as they get back into play, obviously taking a water break, 1,000 people. 1,000 seat capacity we have here at the stadium. Obviously, you and I enjoying the press box. We got a little bit of AC going on right now. Just beautiful state of the art, Drew, and feel really privileged to be up here with you tonight.
Again, if you're just joining us, special ribbon cutting ceremony taking place about an hour and a half before our kickoff tonight. Here you take a look at this gorgeous complex and the great video board, state of the art, right there midfield. We'll be watching a special feature on that board during halftime. Fans will be treated to a high school tribute, Seabreeze Soccer,
yep.
State champions.
Yeah.
In 2017.
For a person who needs their soccer fix, I mean, this is certainly the opiate for that, is it not? We have a, you know, we're going to, these teams are going to meet again, Drew, I have a feeling, because in November 3rd through 5th, we're going to be hosting the conference tournament, and certainly with the teams that, one of them you're watching right now, ASA Miami, Polk State, Broward State, of course us, so we're going to see each other again, I have a feeling. I'm not trying to be a prognosticator, but that's what I'm feeling right now.
So 2-0 still the score. As we're approaching the 25th minute. Still tons of soccer to be played, and you can just sense Daytona State just wants to have a good possession here, Ted. Let everybody touch, perhaps slow the game down just a little bit and get a little bit more in the flow.
Right now, what they were trying to do, obviously, felt... they're trying to go weak side, strong side, weak side, strong strong side, to try to catch the you know, obviously one of the flanks out of position. It's a good strategy that they're trying to apply right now.
Ball lost, Daytona State. See the bench over there trying to fire up their fellow Falcons.
That's right. Be the 12th man, guys. Right, for both teams. The both benches. They need to egg on their. And encourage their teammates.
Been some great matchups in this rivalry already through the last 2 years. And who can forget the one that eventually went to PKs last season, tied it 2. Daytona State went on to win it 9-8 in penalty kicks.
And I'm sure for, you know, EFS, a tough way to lose. I've been in those matches, and it just feels horrible when you're walking off the field when you have to give it up to PKs. You'd rather leave it on the field. The heck with the penalty kicks. But sooner or later, after a double overtime, I mean, it's got to go somewhere.
Yep.
And we were lucky enough to come. I'm sorry, DSC. Lucky enough to come on top for that one.
That's probably the most memorable showdown, I think, that these two programs have had. But certainly I think you can add tonight to that list considering the type of night it has been so far for the Falcons with this great facility being honored as Dixon tosses it in for the Titans. Early goals by Dodomo, number 16, and Lowe, number 14. Dodomo a forward, Lowe a midfielder for Eastern Florida State. That's where we stand right now at 2-0. There you see another case of a little bit of sloppy ball handling in the midfield.
Yeah, I think that was.
How about this play now? Here's Rosary trying to get ahead, and it will belong to the Titans. So we're going to have a free kick coming up here. And this one's not going to be too far outside the 18, so the wall will have to be formed here for Daytona State. Feet got tied up that time.
Yeah.
Official right there to make the call. So you got to watch the rebound here. If D'Amico can send back the initial shot.
And you can see how many players Eastern Florida is keeping back. In that particular time, I mean, that was only two or three Eastern Florida State offenders in the 18-yard box. So they're really playing back. They don't want a counterattack.
That counter so far has been deadly for Eastern Florida.
Right, yeah, DSC being on the losing end of the stick in those particular occurrences, and certainly right now trying to turn that around.
D'Amico comes up out of the goal. Daytona State has won their last seven matches, but find themselves right now in some unfamiliar territory, trailing 2-0. Now right flank. That ball also taken away. And now whistle's going to come in. A little bit too aggressive there by number 18, Joe O'Sullivan. And the official will talk with him just a bit.
Yeah, Joe's trying to plead his case, but referee, I think in that particular case, was kind not to bring out the yellow card. You could see the referee almost gesturing for his pocket, and I think Joe O'Sullivan, you know, might be just good to just zip it right there and let the referee have a counsel with you.
Certainly times to plead your case and then times to just be quiet and
exactly.
Nod your head, right?
In this particular case, you only have one judge and jury, and that's the head ref.
Joe Sullivan leads Daytona State with 9 goals on the season. Just been outstanding over the past few weeks. Last week in that Thomas University match had 2 goals just in the first half. Now the Titans turn and attack once again. A little bit of hesitation, and Knight will send it back out. Good space to work with so far for Eastern Florida. Alexis now possessing. Lowe will head back to collect.
They're, Eastern Florida doing what any good team would do. They're putting their players in good positions, in triangles, and playing a little bit of keep away.
Trying to tee one up for the shot. What a blast. Max Scherer makes it a 3-0 game. Unbelievable.
That was actually a deflection off the defender. And everything going Eastern Florida's way right now.
Offense kind of lulled the Falcons to sleep just a bit, and then the blast taken by Scherer. So Scherer, the German, watch this. Bam. That ball just had perfect trajectory. It just dipped at the perfect time.
Yeah, the defender got just a little bit of instep to create that type of spin, which was overspin, and just, D'Amico again, he was in a good spot. That was just a bit unlucky. And I'm sure here the Falcons are reeling, wondering what is going on.
I think if you're Daytona State, Ted, you're just trying to get that one positive thing to happen, at least before intermission.
Hey, so, like you said, Drew, I mean, you've seen 5 meetings between these two teams. obviously Eastern Florida trying to get some recompense here. You can't say I blame them. You know, but certainly to do it during the ribbon cutting event, trying to play the spoilers.
Sandage, I think, has really got to try and take advantage. Just kind of take over this match. This is going to be called out as he was clearly past that touchline. But I think number 13, the midfielder here, Ryan Sandage, has got to step up. And this could be a great learning experience for Daytona State. Never been in this position this year. And sometimes you need that match where, you know, things don't go your way to see how you respond, because you know you're going to face more adversity as the season goes long into the postseason.
No, that's a great point. But also, if you think about it, I mean, if you've been four up, one down to a team, and now you're meeting for the sixth time, it is, I don't want to say it's easy to be lackadaisical, but it is easy to feel that you might have, you know, a one-up on them. And that might have played into where they are right now. Referee's going to let that play go. Up, he called it back, even though it was advantage. Good call from the ref at that particular case. And like I said, the ref's been calling it pretty even. Ref sees some, he sees some ticky-tack going on. He's just going to calm everybody down. You know, never underestimate, right? Drew, never underestimate. And I'm not saying that's what the Falcons have done here.
And now another chance at a counter for Eastern Florida. Oh, they have got great speed. Here's Alexis. Alexis trying to get a good angle. Pulls it back now.
You know, Drew, that was an interesting play that just developed on the the offensive end of Daytona, but the head skip was missed, and here you are with a counterattack for EFS.
Scherrer laid it off, and a shot taken this time by Alexis. D'Amico is there to take care of it. Three goals conceded in the first half by Phil D'Amico.
I think we're going to find those set plays for DSC. When I was talking about, you know, efficiency before and effectiveness, those set plays can be a great attribute to those two words in the upcoming plays. Because you're going to see more fouls from both sides.
So for Eastern Florida, goals by Lowe, Dodomo, and Scherrer to give them a 3-0 lead. An amazing start here at Daytona State College. Shaw, bicycle attempt. Ball got a little bit past that time, and now the Falcons will try and track it down. Titans have just been a little bit quicker to the ball tonight when they've had big.
Great acrobatic attempt with the bicycle kick. When we were young, we used to call it the Pele.
I think everybody tried to do that at one time or another, right?
Yeah, it was just a matter of trying not to hurt yourself. You don't do it on the concrete.
Now the Titans continuing to be a threat, possessing it will. Alexis, defenders surrounding them. And I think, Ted, one observation, Titans have looked very comfortable when they've gotten deep. However, on the other side, the Falcons have not looked as comfortable on the other end. I think Eastern Florida establishing their offense. Let's take another look at that bicycle attempt, though. Good idea.
Oh, just a little bit missed time, but I mean, that's one of the hardest balls to take out of the air and do.
That was a Miri for the Falcons. Now a little time and space to work with for Manny Perez. Perez lays it off. And a corner kick coming up for Daytona State.
Just what I was talking about. These set pieces are going to become more and more important. So certainly with a corner or a foul near the 18-yard box, this is where you need to capitalize. If you're down 3-0 as the DSC Falcons are right now.
Miguel De Leon right there, 7 goals on the year. This guy could take over a game. They need his offense right now.
You know, I like what you said before also, Drew, about, you know, okay, you're down 3-0. I mean, how do you apply the pressure? The thing is not to lose your cool, to realize that there's still an opportunity out there. Again, needing to get that one goal to start is very important.
Top of the box now, straight on shot, just a little bit high, but that's the best look that the Falcons have had so far tonight.
Correct. Correct. Great shot. He even had his knee over the ball. The trajectory obviously a bit too high, but the mechanics, I think, were well done.
How about De Leon playing out of position most of this year? The attacking mid, playing on the outside, left and right. So trying to find his way. He's done just that. 7 goals, proof of that. About 10 minutes to play here until intermission at Daytona State. Falcons still looking for their first goal. Here come the Falcons attacking. Charlton shot his high. Maybe let it go just a little bit too soon.
Not sure what he was thinking there. Maybe he wanted to deke it over the keeper's head. Right idea, just not the right execution. Again, some nice control shown by EFS.
Alexis coming back the other way. Titans trying to get it in position again, and Falcons defense finally able to recover.
I tell you, they got some dangerous firepower up there.
Now let's see if Daytona State can get it upfield, Ted.
They're talking, they're working it side to side.
Good cohesion now from Daytona State. Team in black desperately needs something good to happen. A little bit of space to work with on the left side, and an errant pass be recovered by Eastern Florida.
Now, even some of the deflections can be disconcerting if you're the Falcons right now. Certainly kind of falling toward the Titans' way at this point in time.
Trying to force corner kick, and let's see, they will be awarded one.
Well done for the work, hard work there out in the flat, out in the flank.
Dixon gets a little talking too.
I think he was giving a little lip to the ref, and the ref said he'll have none of it.
Now it's Marko Tomić, center mid. See if he can put this one in a good spot. Oh, the goalie, Nortar Donato, went up high, climbed the ladder to reel that one down. That's where that size really comes into play.
Dangerous corner. Good job on both sides. Good job with the keep, and certainly had some mustard on that ball to make it a little bit more difficult. Max Scherer from Germany there. I mean, he's strong on the ball.
Ball won by the Titans. Falcons starting to really exert their will. That's a good hustle play by Perez.
Starting to apply more pressure. Yeah, starting to apply more pressure now.
Ball nearly got inside the 6. See if Daytona State can track this one down.
They're going to need numbers over there. They're regrouping. Smart play there by O'Sullivan.
Golikowski now will toss it in for Daytona State. About 6.5 minutes to play here in the first half. Boy, just a goal here from Daytona State I think would be huge here moving forward. Something to build on before intermission. And there's a good save by Nortar Donato again. So when the sophomore has been tested a few times in this first half, he has definitely answered the bell.
You know, the crowd a little bit quieted right now by what has transpired. We need to get that crowd into the game a little bit. Start pounding on the stands and making some noise. I mean, this is the most number of fans I've seen since I've been doing these games, and it's certainly a wonderful turnout. They may be a little disappointed, but they're going to have to do some rah-rahs and some cheers to get this team inspired.
Bench is up right now for Daytona State. Torkowski throws it in for Eastern Florida, and now the Titans play it with Knight, the midfielder out of Jamaica. Jamaica well represented here in this game tonight. Of course, Craigton Charlton, the Daytona State star, hailing from Jamaica. Also have Donovan Segree, another Falcon with Jamaican heritage.
It was a nice idea. Well, you see the numbers right now. You have five back for Eastern Florida, and we only had two up for Daytona State, and that's going to be a little bit more difficult. We're going to have to, I think you'll see Coach Sesnett change the strategy a little bit for the second half.
You can see that Daytona State bench, every little thing they're starting to applaud over there. I think that's a memo from Coach. Let's build on the little things, and eventually something big will happen.
Exactly. Be that 12th person.
Good one-on-one skill this time from Alexis. He'll back it up now and take it on that far side. Eastern Florida with a 3-0 lead. Daytona State trying to build some kind of momentum here. If you are Eastern Florida, Ted, what should be the strategy moving forward?
I think, Coach, 12 trees. I mean, that was played from the ground. Let that play go on.
And finally a whistle. And this ball will be awarded to Daytona State.
I think Coach 12 trees has it right now. You see basically him keeping one striker continuously up front. And then you have, I believe it's Scherer, that's coming up alongside Wanga.
Titans continuing to attack, not sitting back on a 3-0 lead. Alexis, good pass, top of the 18. Eastern Florida trying to sneak another pass through. D'Amico's got to come out and play it.
Good job, good communication there. But again, just a few offenders causing dangerous situations up front for DSC. No, we've been talking about how these teams have met before and they're starting to get familiar with each other. Guaranteed, there will be a different game preparation the next time these two meet.
Without question. And likely going to be one more meeting in the postseason. Daytona State trying to mount some offense here. Here's Perez. And the pass a little bit too far forward, was looking for O'Sullivan that time. It's been those little communication sequences that have just not been fully on point here tonight for the home team.
I mean, I know Perez, what he was looking for. He's looking for a little chip. It just came off the instep pretty hard. He wasn't looking for it that way, certainly not.
What do you think, Coach Mark Sassanet's going to tell his team at halftime? I mean, clearly, it's a half you learn from, but it's certainly one that you don't want to remember too much because it's probably the worst half of the season.
He's going to give him a bit of an earful, of course. Just talking about the 50-50 balls, don't get frustrated with some of the deflections, but also play, Falcon ball. And as you've mentioned before, just, you know, some of the miscommunications up front, I don't think there was a lot of miscommunication in the back. It just happened to be some great plays that developed for, you know, Eastern Florida. So he'll be talking about offense, communication, and also strategy to offset what the...
Good ball downfield. Falcons trying to catch up to it right in front of the goal. Notar Tanano able to make another save. Perez comes up to apply pressure. But again, danger averted by the Titans.
Yeah, that was thwarted, but again, a good play.
Final 20 seconds from Daytona State Soccer Stadium. Not the first half we envisioned, but still 45 minutes to play, and can be sure Daytona State will make some adjustments at intermission. And credit Eastern Florida. Titans have come in, and they have played probably their best half of the season. Combined, the best half from Eastern Florida and probably the worst for Daytona State, and you've got the 3-0 deficit. Max Scherrer, number 17, had the, I think, most exciting goal that we saw with that blast outside the 18. That was as good a goal as I think we've ever seen.
Certainly powerful. He's a big kid. Certainly has size, skill, agility. I mean, he's the full package. He's the type of player that, you know, Coach 12 Trees was talking about as far as moving on progressively to D1. And then who knows, you know, what the future will hold. But he's got the strength and obviously the length.
So Scherrer, the German, making it a 3-0 game. But before that, had a big goal by Dodomo. Had another by Lowe, number 14, freshman on this Eastern Florida roster. Guarantee you, with all the festivities going on, Eastern Florida took notice and said, you know what, I think we have an opportunity tonight to catch this Daytona State team maybe just a little bit off balance, perhaps even thinking forward towards the postseason. And let's take a look now at some of the highlights from the first half. As the action, Charlton trying to initiate it, and Notar Tanano able to deflect that one. He was in the right spot at the right time. Eastern Florida coming right back on the counter. That one versus one move was just tremendous there as Lowe stuck it into the back of the net. There's Lowe on the goal there. That first goal was by Dodomo. Lowe had the second. Eastern Florida starting to control the action. Daytona State a little bit frustrated, and then this blast, just awesome from Max Scherrer.
Yeah, Max Scherrer, again, just a bit of a deflection. Here's a great play for DSC. Again, efficiency, effectiveness, not equaling up right now for DSC Falcons.
Right now, Seabreeze High School honored here at intermission. Well, Daytona State here, this is among the premier colleges in the nation for the overall academic experience as well as being a student athlete. We can all agree there is no place quite like Daytona State College.
Coming into a brand new program, it was a little nerve-wracking at first. You know, I had to put a lot of trust in Bart when I met with him. You know, he really sold me on this place and just the idea of building a family and a really good program. So coming here, I was nervous at first, but then right when I stepped on the field, I knew we had something special here.
After I got here, met the teammates, everything went well. We started practicing, everything was going good. And we had a good season, we went to nationals.
Coming to this program that had just started from scratch was absolutely amazing. Didn't know anybody, made a load of new friends, a load of new connections. We came together very easily, easier than I expected as a family. And we meshed together, went to nationals last year. Didn't work out as we planned, but it was incredible. In saying that, since all that happened, brought us to nationals and stuff, we ended up getting a new field and stuff, and amazing from here on.
Oh, I love the new stadium. I mean, we get all this exposure with the TV, the production and everything, so we got a bunch of good players. It's going to help move people on to the next level. and we're all the more excited to just play here because it's in our house now.
And no, we're playing in a nice grass field. That's amazing. It's an amazing feeling.
Like back where I'm from in Ireland, you normally don't have that type of stuff unless you're made a professional or whatever. And to have all those packed out seats, Jumbotron, nice field, incredible.
So Coach really puts academics first. He always reminds us that we're students before we're athletes. And I think that academics and soccer go hand in hand. I can take things from soccer, like my work ethic, and apply them to school, and then the same thing vice versa, the discipline to do my homework and bring it onto the field.
You know that they want you to do good, like not just for them to benefit, but also they want to see you succeed in life after you leave here so you can go like to a good university.
Doing well in the classroom is like, it's a motivation thing as well as doing well on the field. If you're not motivated in the class, you're just not a motivated person and you're not gonna succeed. So Coach harps on about we have to get our grades and stuff, but he's right. Getting our grades is doing well on the field also, because you get your chance to play. If you're not getting your grades, you don't play. Simple as, and it's all in the mindset.
Well, we're doing pretty well. We lost one game. We played 10 and lost one game.
The one, don't ask about it. It was a slip up, but after that we bounced back as a family like we do. And
this year we've got a couple big wins under our belt. We beat some big teams and we're really coming into form at the end of the season, which is important. Playoffs are coming up and I think that we're really starting to hit our peak. I think the future of this program is it's just going to keep getting better. I think we're going to continue to be the best team in our conference. We proved that last year, and I think it's with the exposure, more kids are going to come here, and I just think we're going to continue to win nationals year after year.
No matter where I go for school after this, I'll always be a member of this family, and I want to see this program and this school in general just succeed. Continuously making it to nationals, continuously producing great players, sending them off to great schools, and just seeing the coaches do well as well.
Express yourself through the art of dance at Daytona State College. With a variety of classes offered in modern dance, jazz dance, and ballet, there is an outlet for your creativity. From beginners to more advanced performers, there is a place for you. Non-dancers and fitness enthusiasts will benefit from the stretch and placement class, featuring conditioning in a fitness class setting. For students with prior training and performance experience, the DSC Dance Theater performs at on- and off-campus venues. Limited scholarships are available.
Daytona State College of Education is forever grateful to Volusia and Flagler County Schools and our collaborative partnership that allows us to spend this exciting time out in the field working with these wonderful students, doing one-on-one reading instruction 4 days a week.
Daytona State has definitely prepared me for being a teacher with all the fieldwork that we've been able to experience. through the program, as well as the support and help from all of our wonderful professors. And being able to work one-on-one with the students has been a wonderful opportunity to experience that already before I get placed in my senior internship.
DSC Soccer Complex will be an outstanding sports venue that will attract a loyal Falcon fan base in the community we have here today. Equally significant, it will become a learning laboratory for students in our upcoming sports broadcasting TV program.
It's fantastic. The new facility is fantastic. We can't complain. The surface is grass. It's wonderful. It's a big field. We have great support. Dr. Labasso got his jumbo screen behind us, and that's a great experience for the fans, and obviously the girls like it. So, you know, it's a very, very nice place to train every day. It's a great place to hold games, and we're very grateful for the opportunity to be in it.
It feels amazing. I mean, the stands, everything looks great. You know, it's just a plus. I mean, we're a good team, so that just brings us, you know, more energy to play and win.
Being a brand new program is really exciting, and the fact that we're competing so well against these teams that have been together for a long time feels really good. And having a new stadium as a new program is really rewarding, especially since our season last year was so good.
It feels great coming here. I mean, I was here last year, and the new stadium was something we always looked forward to last year. We were just like, oh, I can't wait to play in our stadium on campus. And the best part is that we have the TV program, so it helps expose our team. We got a really good team, so I'm just excited every time we get to step out here.
You gotta find a way to put the ball in the back of the net more consistently when you get those chances. Because when you're playing a good team, you're not gonna get that many chances. So you gotta maximize your opportunities.
Welcome back to Daytona State College Soccer Stadium here on a gorgeous Tuesday night. Titans of Eastern Florida State College in town to take on the Falcons. And right now they enjoy a 3-0 lead over Daytona State. I'm Drew Felios alongside Ted Sofianos, and at halftime, Daytona State head coach Bart Sasnett taking advantage of this opportunity to prepare his team for adversity to come in the postseason. Coach Sasnett, you know, just making the point, hey, we are not playing our brand of soccer. We still have 45 minutes to get things together and at least making something positive happen out of tonight, Ted.
You know darn well he would love to come out with just a draw on this one. And right now he's talking to them about 50-50 balls, running into space, communication. You know, tactically speaking, I mean, you didn't see too many breakdowns, but again, E equals E. When you have effectiveness and efficiency going together, they only had, when I say they, I mean EFS, only had a few tries on net, and I think they were three out of five.
All right, some spectacular goals we saw from Eastern Florida in that first half, but I think the most exciting one was number 17, Max Scherrer. Watch him give this one a blast. This one, I believe, was the second goal. Yes, that
correct.
One was scored, and then this one by number 17. That was the second goal. And then let's take a look as the scoring continue. That was low, able to connect from the Titans. And we'll see if we can get a look at that goal by Max Scherrer, the one that was blasted outside the 18.
Yeah, and as we get the chance to see that third goal, you're going to see it just deflect slightly off the instep of the DSC defender's boot if that comes up. But no matter what, I mean, it put overspin on the ball, and I mean, just deadly for the keeper, D'Amico. And certainly not to take anything away from EFS, but certainly they've capitalized on their chances. But secondly, the ball seems to be bouncing a little bit more in their favor than DSC Falcons. right now, if you're the DSC Falcons, Drew, I mean, there's a lot of pressure to put something in the net within the first few minutes of the game.
I was mentioning the goal by Scherrer at the end of the first half, because I think a 2-0 deficit still, I think you're within striking range if you're Daytona State, but this one right here, this blast by Scherrer, I think could be, if this score holds, the goal that kind of took the wind out of everybody's sails. Still, 45 minutes to play. Daytona State can still make something happen, but D'Amico just frozen on that shot.
And certainly he wasn't in a poor position. That type of overspin on a soccer ball only comes one way, and like I said before, from that slight deflection. We've had a couple in front as well, and when I say we, I mean Daytona State, the home team. They've had a few deflections as well. Obviously, they're getting it together right now. They're trying to encourage each other. They know it can be done, but I guarantee they want to put a good showing on for the second half and turn it around.
Falcons wearing the black tonight. Eastern Florida, Titans in the white. Golikowski, number 24, has played well. Miguel De Leon, number 19, 7 goals. Somebody's going to spark this team. 19 could be the guy to do it. Also, Joe O'Sullivan with 9 goals on the season. So 16 goals combined from those two, 18 and 19. Falcons need them to make some noise here in the second half. So about to get underway. Women's volleyball match coming up October 17th. You can also watch that one as Eastern Florida, the Titans, come calling. Love this rivalry, Daytona State and Eastern Florida. And Daytona State having another outstanding volleyball season as well. Cannot wait to bring that to you.
Yeah, Daytona State certainly has some great teams, men's and women's basketball, men's and women's soccer, men's baseball, women's golf, been a juggernaut. For a long time now with Coach Laura Brown. Women's softball, women's volleyball, and men's and women's cross country coming in the fall of 2018.
Sports continue to expand here at Daytona State. Eastern Florida attacking here in the opening minutes of the second half. Shot taken, and the Falcons a little slow getting back that time as the Titans will set up for a corner kick. Not the way you want to start the second 45.
We want to start dangerous. Eastern Florida, I mean, still applying the pressure. Guaranteed, though, Coach 12 Trees is going to do it with fewer men up front. They're going to sit back on this 3-goal lead and covet it for as long as they possibly can. Opposingly, it's DSC's job to have a quick one in within the 10-minute mark.
This one placed right in the arms of D'Amico. Daytona State's only lost one game this season. And right now, they're just trying to get that one goal here tonight.
You mentioned it before, Drew, though. You know, sometimes when you've won so many and only lost one, this is could be a great learning experience for Daytona State going forward as they approach the conference tournament.
Pre-game ceremony for this tremendous state-of-the-art soccer complex. The Bermuda grass. And we were at near capacity tonight in the bleachers. Good a crowd as we've ever seen. Here, Falcons trying to get this one within striking range. Try the cross, handball called, and finally the flag goes up. So we could have a penalty kick here, and I believe we will.
Well, if you could have summed up exactly what the doctor ordered, well, here you go. At the 2-minute mark, to start the second half, they're looking at a possible score with a PK.
So golden opportunity for Daytona State to build some momentum here. Ryan Sandage is the heart of this program, the engine that makes this thing go. This team needs him here big time. Notar Donato in the net for Eastern Florida. Here we go.
Here's the whistle.
Sandage able to deliver. And finally, the Falcons, after 48 grueling minutes, finally on the board.
Very fortuitous right there with the handball. And here we're going to look at the replay in just a sec. There it is. And you see why he got called. He stuck his hand out, and the referee just couldn't let that one go, especially in the 18-yard box. Certainly a good call by the referee, good eyes.
So Ryan Sandage, very tactical player for Daytona State, not known as a heavy goal scorer. Able to give Falcons a little bit of momentum here, and 3-1. Definitely Falcons not out of the woods just yet. Looking for a call there, and not going to get it as Adrisu threw his body out of bounds.
That was a mean shoulder there, but no call.
Drew Felios and Ted Sofiano's definitely been an interesting night so far. Eastern Florida has brought their A game. Daytona State mainly on defense for most of the night, but let's see if they can continue the momentum with Sandage delivering.
Yeah, for Daytona State Falcons, it's a matter of keeping up the pressure, playing your game, and do not play it like you're down 3-1 with 2 minutes to go. Realize what you have in front of you time-wise, skill level, and that you have the ability to perhaps come out with a 3-3 tie.
See slowly the passing getting a little bit better for Daytona State. And I think the players looking a little bit more confident here and settled here than what they did in the first half.
I'm sure Coach Sazna is very impressed, not particularly with that first play of the game, but certainly with where the pace is right now, running onto space, running, to those 50-50 balls, challenging them much more powerfully than before.
Now it's low.
And if you're coach 12 trees, I mean, that one goal certainly creates just a little bit of tenuousness.
Adrisu got it to Rosary. Now the cross. And the Titans will go back and get it. Gonzalez collecting now for Eastern Florida. Here's George. Switches field. Dixon. We'll try and put it in position and headed just outside the 18. Rosary lays it off on that right side. And now another cross attempt is going to be into the hands of D'Amico.
Looks like the ball went out and came back in. That's resulting in a goal kick.
For all the adversity that they have faced, Daytona State has done a pretty good job keeping their cool so far. Keep in mind they've got 11 yellow cards this season, only one red. It's a good sign, although it did come to their goalie, Phil D'Amico. This team has played with cool heads pretty much all season. Falcons will now have to reset inside the center circle.
And I'm sure you just saw that play go into the box. How many did Daytona State have in that 18-yard box during that cross? And the answer would be one player. Going to have to figure out how to get a few more in there to strategically balance the number of defenders that DSC is facing right now.
Now's a flick in some time and space to work with. De Leon tried to center it. And we're going to have another flag, or whistle rather, and it's going to be another set piece coming up.
Yeah, it looks like
for
to be about
State.
27 yards out. And these are those set pieces that I said are so important. And guarantee that Coach Saznet has a set piece up his sleeve for this particular play.
Charlton and Tomich hovering over the ball now.
You know, I love that they've done this. They've done this for a number of years now with the 10-step pace off and then, of course, putting down some chalk. So that way the there's no issues how far back they should be.
Now it's Charlton. Charlton, the ball squirts through and into the hands of Natar Donato, who collects another one. Like the sense of urgency so far in the second half from Daytona State. The Falcons want to make sure, even though they don't, even if they don't come out on the winning end on the scoreboard, still have to be into this game from start to finish, considering all the support that they have gotten tonight. You got to give the home fans a show, and I think they're doing that right now.
No, exactly.
Ball taken away.
Referee letting a little bit of play go there.
Another pass sneaks through. The goalie a little confused. D'Amico wasn't sure whether to come up or stay back, and Lowe nearly made him pay.
Just giving it up in the middle there a little bit, you know, in the middle right there with a, you know, dispossessed, and it almost resulted in an EFS goal.
You know, interesting, you look at both sidelines. There's the Daytona State bench. Everybody eager off the bench into the game. Right now on the other side, a lot more laid back, trying to sit on that 3-1 lead.
Right, that, you know, you got to be the 12th man. Got to encourage your teammates. And sitting back and relaxing there as they were in the first half, I think Coach Saznet has told them, let's have a change of mentality here.
Just over 36 minutes to play, so plenty of time still on the clock for Daytona State. We've seen so many flurries of goals this year from these Falcons. Making up two can be very easy, but against this Eastern Florida team and the caliber of talent, I think a little bit different story tonight, but anything is possible, certainly.
Wow, a bit of an interesting call there. It's going to be Eastern Florida State ball.
Torkowski to throw this one in, sophomore out of Melbourne. So hometown guy for the Titans.
So I'm sure you recall back to the first half after they went up two goals. We did not flood their third of the field, and we are doing so now, so certainly a strategic change.
Tell you what, those midfielders attacking the 18 of Daytona State, sneaking those passes through, that has been something that Daytona State has really struggled to deal with tonight. Whistle blown.
Thinks Shera's gonna get a card.
I think first time tonight, the card coming out. And it will be for Scherer.
You know, I keep doing the tomato-tomato thing. You're right, it's Scherer. I keep saying Scherer. Let me get it right next time.
Pretty solid officiating.
Oh, they're doing a great job.
Throughout this contest, as you see Scherer go to the bench. You know, in a rivalry match is clearly a foul there by Scherer. It's gonna be a little bit more physical, a little bit more intense. I think there's that happy medium. You gotta let the two teams play. Let them do their thing. Natar Donato comes down with it, and that was a collision. right inside the box that time. Player shaken up.
Yeah, he might have gotten a knee to the kidney, it looks.
That's O'Sullivan. Joe Sullivan, a sophomore out of Pine Ridge High School. And the training staff will now come out to get a look at number 18. But this was a play where he got caught in an awkward spot, went airborne with Natar Donato, and Bryce Natar Donato with a bit of physical play there.
Yeah, he's a lanky guy. It looks like the right knee came up and hit O'Sullivan right in the back. He's writhing in pain right now. He's really struggling to get up.
I think could be also maybe the wind knocked out of him as well. Just the way you see him moving around.
I'm sure the Falcon fans are hoping just for that. Similarly, you hope it's nothing too serious, except, of course, a nasty bruise.
So Coach Sasnett knew how much was going into tonight, how badly he wanted his team to play well, playing in front of the Board of Trustees. Said that, you know, it's no secret, our main goal as a program, when we look at our schedule every year, when are we playing? Eastern right. Florida State College. So tonight's game right. certainly comes with a bunch of importance. This, yeah. though, another blow if they do lose Joe O'Sullivan. Here's one more look. Watch him. This angle should be better, too, from the side, seeing where he got caught. And it was the knee right into the side, right there.
Yeah, that definitely has to be painful. I mean, you see that in real time. I mean, you know that can feel crippling from behind like that. He is communicating with the trainers.
See one of his close friends right there, Almir Kurtanovich. O'Sullivan, the look on his face says it all.
And of course, I'm sure 95% pain, but you know, there's probably a bit of frustration. He probably does not want to come out.
Daytona State College Falcons gathering donations for the relief in Puerto Rico. Such a devastating situation. We invite you to visit dscfalcons.com for donations on the relief to Puerto Rico. Great job by student body here, faculty as well, organizing that relief.
Yeah, both students, faculty, administration, staff, all coming together to pitch in for those affected by the hurricane.
Good crowd on hand here tonight at Daytona State Soccer Stadium. And I know that the Falcons wish that up until now they could have put on a little better show, but Eastern Florida, top caliber program, they have owned the moment so far tonight. 3-1 is your score still. 34 minutes and change to play here. Lots of time remaining. Daytona State's played much better in the second half. Let's see if they can keep it going.
Trying to see, Drew, if somebody came in for O'Sullivan.
I believe it's Scott Benoit, number 12, who is inserted into the game. Now some numbers for the Falcons. Benoit! Ball nearly got to him if it did. That could have been a goal there. Here's Amiri. Get this one ahead. Benoit trying to chase it down. So let's see if some fresh legs off the bench.
Oh, a lot of pushing and shoving there.
And the The official did not see the first push. Yeah, you know, he saw the second one.
It's one of those where he picked up on the second one. I mean, somebody was going to get called. Unfortunately for DSC, it was one of their own.
Bryce Notardinato, sophomore goalie out of Merritt Island, trying to preserve a 3-1 lead for Eastern Florida.
Yeah, you try to get it in your head, mentally speaking. I mean, you're only down 2-0. You know, that's where you know, the DSC players are going to be told to think right now from Coach Sasnett. And that is certainly something that you can overcome or equalize.
De Leon. De Leon sends it far side. Ball. Oh, there's a hold. And nothing called, clearly. It looked like a Falcon was held just outside the six.
Drew surprised me on that one. The referee did not blow the whistle.
So we play on. Now it's De Leon. Overall, the tempo, gotta like it much better if you're a fan of Daytona State. Being a little bit more opportunistic here in the second 45. Here's Lowe now attacking.
What I'm seeing is DSC playing with more purpose right now, more emphasis, and certainly, but not playing scared, not playing as if you know, it's a last-ditch effort. I like what they're trying to put together right here. There's some development in play, possession of ball, and putting the numbers where they need to be.
Now it's De Leon trying to get it to that corner. He is taken down. And a whistle right there. So officials starting to step in and tighten this game up just a little bit. That was Dixon on the infraction that time. Let's take a look at the last one in the box that we think could have and should have been a hold. Let's take one more look. Right here.
Oh, clear foul. Clear foul. I don't see how the referee missed it, but unfortunately for the Falcons, that he let that one go.
That was Manny Perez, who probably should have gotten that whistle. Now Tomic, Marco Tomic, sophomore center mid with the set piece. Tomic collects again, puts it into the danger zone. Falcons trying to keep it alive in front of the goal. Oh, what a great save.
Wonderfully done.
Korkowski right in the middle of that number five.
Goalie was certainly out of position. And there, what was it, the Eastern Florida State defender was in the right place, right time to head that over the bar.
Now the in-swinger, Dylan Burke. Another opportunity for Daytona State. Gotta like the way they're working on these set pieces. Altogether, the effort much better in the second half from the Falcons. But gotta be careful, they're not susceptible here to the counter again from Eastern Florida.
You can see though, they're pushing a lot more folks up front for the DSC Falcons. Certainly a change in strategy for DSC.
The Falcons could somehow find a way to get one more goal, Ted. This stadium.
It's going to erupt.
There's going to be tremendous energy.
Now, you don't always see a defender being the last one on the line to make that kind of save with his head. And Eastern Florida State was well in to save a goal from that challenge.
Titans attacking from that left flank. And that's an easy ball for D'Amico to take care of.
I like the aggressive distribution out to the left wing there.
Saw Adriso beat De Leon to it that time. Really, you know, impressed by the speed tonight. of Eastern Florida. How many balls that they've been able to get to first?
Quite a few. It looks like the 50-50 balls right now have been in Eastern Florida's favor. But I do like the pressure that DSC is now showing.
Player down right now, that's Rosary. And that could very well be some cramping here as we near the late segments of this game. That's Oliver Twelvetrees, head coach of Eastern Florida, helping his player off the field. Rosary, a freshman out of Toronto, Canada. Dylan Burke to throw it in for Daytona State. Another player goes down. This one, a Falcon. Good pass ahead. Eastern Florida. Do not count them out offensively just yet. Falcons, though, able to recover that time. And another player goes down, and we're getting really physical now.
Yeah, he's got to call that. It was a great call by the ref from behind. Referee going to leave the card alone at this point. Showing weak side, far side distribution for Daytona State. And Eastern Florida well in to get the deflection off the Daytona State player. It's going to be East Florida State ball.
Remember the last time we were here, last Wednesday, the wind was such a factor in that game against Thomas University JV. Well, tonight, not nearly as much. You see the flags in the corner of the stadium. A little bit of wind, but it's picked up a little bit more here tonight.
Light breeze actually in favor of the Falcons at this point. But certainly not a tremendous factor in the scheme of things. Still got 27 minutes plus remaining. Eastern Florida State, I'd say, probably laying back a little bit on a two-goal lead.
Gonzalez, ball deflected again off of Falcon, so it'll be Eastern Florida throwing once again.
You know, you can only burn the fuel so much, and I know they're putting a lot of emphasis right now, running down those challenges, trying to end up with the 50-50 balls, trying to equalize. You expend a tremendous amount of energy when you're trying to do that.
Falcons trying to turn it north-south. Benoit, his run cut off once again. Benoit got to do a little bit better job keeping the ball.
Yeah, that would have just been better to play a little bit of, 3v1 or 3v2 in the corner.
Oh, another push right there. And a whistle comes in to Domo, trying to exert his physicality.
Yeah, Eastern Florida State certainly with the with more fouls than the Falcons. Set pieces being in the Falcons' favor at this point. Just a bit too relaxed while receiving that ball.
What a run it has been for Daytona State over the last seven matches. All W's, USC Sumter, Kaiser, ASA out of Miami, Weber, Thomas University, Broward, and Weber International JV in those seven victories. 7-0 in those matches. And that streak of seven straight in jeopardy right now. A two-goal lead for Eastern Florida, 25 minutes plus yet to play. This is De Leon. Falcons trying to distribute here. Tomic, good pass. Now here's the cross in, and that one's just got too much on it.
Too much. I mean, great idea, just didn't keep it low enough. Might have been looking for far post on that one, but nobody was home.
Still, you hear the words of encouragement. This crowd has done a great job hanging in with the Falcons tonight. Goal this, scored by Ryan Sandage.
You know, this this television broadcast, Drew, is also to start a new season for the Associate of Science in Broadcast Television Production, which is a degree program which provides students with hands-on experience through DSC's public TV station, WDSE. We also have a few other programs like to highlight while we have just kind of a lull in activity. We have a new degree in beverage science. It has to do with some hops, barley, fermentation. I think some people know what I'm talking about. And that's happening over at the Husseini Center in the culinary area.
And see substitute Carlos Calicchio comes in for Daytona State. This is the 60th anniversary of Daytona State College. Such an awesome year, 2017, to be a part of what is going on here in Daytona Beach.
You know, you got to wonder if EFS, Eastern Florida State, prevails in this match, is it good medicine for the Falcons later on?
Shot by Dodomo, taken in by D'Amico.
You know, will it be good medicine as far as other games are concerned, you know, knowing and learning from a game like this?
Eastern Florida retreating, but able to keep possession. Falcons come up and apply pressure, miss an opportunity there, and it's been those little balls that just have not gone Daytona State's way tonight.
You know, some folks might have thought that was a foul, but actually Eastern Florida State player did a great job in shielding and keeping possession for that play. But again, Falcons running down play.
So throwing on the far side from Eastern Florida State. Owen Torkowski will do the honors there. Ball in the box and scored. The header is in by Dodomo. That's his second goal of the night. And that one is going to just about do it.
All right, don't over-celebrate too much, gang. Just a lapse in defense there, a fortuitous bounce, and a header well in by Eastern Florida State player. Number 16, Dodomo. Dodomo, pronounced Dodomo.
Dodomo, the sophomore out of London. What a talent he is. His size has really been critical in the box. Just able to get loose there, and Dylan Burke marking him had no shot. Titans continuing to play forward. Dodomo trying to sneak free again. And here's Burke again, the captain, the hard-nosed Irishman, to send it out of bounds. I'll just want to reiterate, Ted, that Daytona State homecoming kicking off next week with women's volleyball as they take on Eastern Florida State College. That's a 7 p.m. match live on WDSC. Women's volleyball team, what a season they're having right now. 19-3 record, currently ranked number 14 in the nation. So volleyball taking on Eastern Florida. Cannot wait for that match next week.
Also have the women's soccer team play ASA Miami next Wednesday, October 18th. That was a rescheduled game due to Hurricane Irma.
Titans trying to shake free again. Just a little too comfortable inside the Daytona State box tonight. That's something that Coach Sasnett, I think, is going to shore up before their next contest. They got 8 days before they take on Broward.
Oh, definitely. And certainly at this point in time, if you're on the losing end, you don't hang your head while you're on the field. You know, you lick your wounds, you learn from the mistakes, and you go forward. And certainly that's, like you said, that's Coach Sesnitz's job to look at, you know, the game film, see where they can improve, compare and contrast, learn from the mistakes, and go forward.
Falcons, nice ball here. Little shove in the back. We play on. Charlton's going to give it a blast, and it goes into the side of the goal. So we'll blow it dead. Creighton Charlton, saw him on that run in the first half, but other than that, 29 has been a little bit quiet, and when he is not playing his best, clearly it shows for the big picture of Daytona State, doesn't it?
Right, exactly, and I think there was just, and you mentioned the word before, Drew, just having some jitters, perhaps the big event, also playing a tough conference game in front of what we've seen now is a packed house. You have your waxes and your wanes. The kids are going to learn from this experience. And as I mentioned before, it might just be darn good medicine.
Dixon and Alexis. Lowe able to get a touch for Eastern Florida as they continue to dominate possession here tonight. Another pass, nearly gets through. D'Amico comes up to play it. And right now, Dylan Burke trying to make sure that three-goal lead stays that for the Titans. Do not want to surrender anymore here at home.
Well, certainly with the rankings, you're going to have Eastern Florida State move up a bit, most likely. DSC might fall a notch or two. We'll see how that shakes out. But it's not over yet, ladies and gentlemen.
So everything was going so perfectly tonight, if you're a fan of Daytona State College, until the game started. And Eastern Florida had other ideas. Interesting to see, though, in the future, we talk about this great stadium, not just going to house Daytona State sports, but also community club tournaments, high school games, also the 2018 NGCAA Division I Men's Soccer Championship. That's also coming here to Daytona Beach. So this stadium is going to be busy, to say the least.
Truly an all-access venue for not only a community college, but the high schools. You're going to have young kids coming out with camps in the summer. You have the Regional 8 Conference Tourney coming up. You're going to have in 2018 hosting the men's national NGCAA teams. There'll be 12 teams in that. Certainly we hope for some of our Florida teams to be involved in that.
Charlton pushed that time. Another whistle is going to be heard. Low, the midfielder, with the infraction.
You know, I was talking about rankings, Drew, and one of the things that might be worth saying right now, we're number one in the state in our Bachelor of Science Education program. We're in the top 10 in the country, according to U.S. News and World Reports, for online studies.
Oh, big shot there. Charlton unloaded on that one. And I believe that caught the head of Lowe as he gets up a little gingerly. And he is feeling that right now. You see 14, kind of goes back to one knee on the field. That was a blast off the foot of Charlton.
A rocket. I would not want to be on the receiving end of that.
Halt action for just a moment. Now we play on. So 4-1. The deficit right now for Daytona State, the one goal, 48th minute by Ryan Sandage, center mid off PK. other than that, Falcons have been kept off the scoreboard. Burke tries to head it back. D'Amico comes up to play it for Daytona State. Nearly falling on it that time. Saw Colicchio, the freshman out of Orlando, Montverde Academy. So for Daytona State, still two regular season matches at Broward next Wednesday on the 18th, and then ASA College out of Miami on October 21st, and then time for the postseason. Should be a heck of a journey again. Got to the second round a season ago. Interesting to see how far Daytona State can go this season. A little taken off that one. Notar Donato able to reel in the pop-up.
Yeah, just offered deflection there.
Scott Benoit. And this could be a PK. Let's see.
I'm not sure what
the ball was juggled. Our official quickly steps in. Whatever it is, Eastern Florida not happy with it.
And I think they might have every right to be. Very rarely do you see an indirect kick awarded next to the 6-yard box.
Well, you saw Dodomo kind of come in there to settle things and keep his teammates off of the referee. But this is going to be probably the most interesting set piece we have ever seen.
I haven't seen this since I've been a youngster. When I used to referee games, I was always told any type of foul that occurs or offense that occurs in the box is going to be a PK. I know there's exceptions. I just haven't seen one in a long time.
So, Ted, try and squeeze the ball through all of those legs in front of the goal. Is it possible? We're about to find out.
Actually, you're probably going to go up top.
I think that'd probably be better odds.
Now, from what I can tell, it looks like an indirect kick, which means it has to be touched twice before it goes in the net. Right, but if he does it again, he's going to get called for a yellow.
Quick kick. Ball still alive, and glove by Notar Donato. How about that play?
Not sure exactly what the play was supposed to be. Looked like it might have been a little broken from the set.
I think now we can certainly say we've seen everything.
Yeah. Well, again, that's a real treat for fans because that very rarely happens. Like to have seen the Falcons make a little bit better of a result with that play.
Titans back to work. Here's Rosary. Aggressively attacking all night long. Lost. And now Daytona State with a counter.
Some great moves. DSC applying numbers up front. And they're half in the offensive half of the DSC's field.
Minutes to play. Here in regulation, 4-1. Eastern Florida cruising right now. Let's see if Daytona State can at least make them a little bit uncomfortable here the rest of the way.
Yeah, normally you saw a shirt tug there, and whether it's, you know, the DSC or EFS, either one, usually that's called a yellow card there. Referees letting it go. Which is fine. I mean, you hate to give yellow cards for ticky-tack stuff like that.
Now the ball in the box, and another clear try that time. Dylan Burke just could not get a good foot on it. I mean, that was spoon-fed that time.
It was certainly spoon-fed. He could have trapped it, had a sandwich, and then kicked it in the goal.
Alexis. Got to count for him on the way back.
I think Dylan didn't expect that one as far as how it came through. I love to see the presence of some of our young middle schoolers as ball girls and ball boys.
Subbing in for the Falcons, number 19, Miguel De Leon, and number 7, Emmanuel Perez.
So Miguel De Leon, 19, comes in. Also Manny Perez re-enters the contest. Corner kick coming up, and it's going to be Knight, the midfielder, out of Kingston, Jamaica, for Eastern Florida. So you got 11 minutes if you're Daytona State. You're going to make something happen. It's got to be right now. Benoit signals for his team to come on, get up the
That's
field.
Right.
Let's go.
Never give up. Love the tenacity there shown.
Keep in mind, Daytona State lost one of their best players, Joe O'Sullivan, earlier on here tonight. So definitely having an effect on the attack. Benoit has replaced him. Not made much of a difference up to this point.
Yeah, I guarantee Joe O'Sullivan got to have an ice pack on that area right now. We hope the best for him.
Benoit's offsides. Actually, that was Charlton that time. Got behind the defense. Easy call for the official.
You know, coach is going to take him back, right, into the training area. You know, as they're all showered up, have a team meeting. Probably going to say, what are some of the takeaways, guys? Want you to think tonight. When you go home, when I see you back next day for practice, what are the takeaways? I want you to reflect a little bit and think about what we did right and some of the things we did wrong. Probably Coach Sazen going to tell. Meanwhile, Eastern Florida certainly building up a little bit of momentum to assuage those four losses they've had to the Falcons.
Titans want more. Another offside's going to be called, though, that time. This one right there to put the flag up.
Little more than 9 minutes left in the game. Certainly this game could be easily 3-2. Was that one header and, of course, the missed 6-yard set piece that could have been the second goal for the Falcons. Again, I haven't seen that. It's been years.
You know, it's interesting. Coach Sasnett raved about his back line, about how they have shored up all the things that they needed to. Is Tartanato able to get on it? Keeps it away from Charlton that time. But, you know, just as he said that and raved about that back line, they struggled a little bit tonight containing the firepower of Eastern Florida, and it happened right from the start, Ted.
Oh, and you know Eastern Florida. I mean, they're a juggernaut. They've got some very well-disciplined and skillful players. And we just a couple occasion kind of deflated the balloon, came on the short end of the stick a couple of times. And that can also be very frustrating when you see a couple of deflections and it ends up in the other team's favor.
Well, Coach Sasson said we got to win the middle of the park tonight, meaning the midfield. That area also struggled, especially in the first half. Second half, I think, has been a little better. But the back, clearly, where the issues have been for Daytona State.
Yeah, and I think they've done a decent job owning the middle of the field for the Falcons. Certainly, Eastern Florida State has done that. Obviously more so, a little bit. But when you think about both midfield games, been impressed by both sides.
This is Mwanga for Eastern Florida in the game, number 21. Love the way that Eastern Florida has worked tonight. They have worked so quickly and efficiently.
Yes, definitely.
De Leon gives chase. Charlton bumped out of bounds by Nascimento. Just under 7 minutes to play. Couple big-time scoring chances in the second half could have been goals for Daytona State, but Eastern Florida, got to give them credit, Ted. When they were threatened, one of them came off that very odd set piece that we just saw minutes ago. Eastern Florida, they answered the bell when they had to.
Yeah, and I, honestly, they've had a few other attempts that could have set them up for a couple of more goals. Some fortuitous bounces, perhaps, for Eastern Florida State, depending on what side of the fans' seating you are. But a very impressive showing by Eastern Florida State. And as you know, if you're Coach Sazen, as you're going to conferences, I mean, to conference tourney, you know, is this a positive thing for the team by knowing just how good this Eastern Florida State team can be? Perhaps, you know, taking that negative and making it a positive if you're a Falcon.
Now it's Dylan Burke, number 3, left back. Part of that back line that was hit hard when Roy O'Keefe was lost the last time these two teams played. Roy O'Keefe, one of the leaders. O'Keefe out of Ireland. That ball going to roll out of bounds. It'll belong to Daytona State.
Now they're still fighting. You know, I love to see it. Whichever team is down, still fighting. That was a nice development on the right wing there. Hide the triangle going.
Well, there is Roy O'Keefe. You know, it's got to be tough for him. Would have been the center back on this squad. Such a talented player out of Ireland. Just a great kid as well. Mm-hmm. Losing a guy his caliber, you know, bodies are going to have to shuffle. And Daytona State, it has taken them a long time, over 3 weeks, to get up to their standard of play without him patrolling that back line. But tonight, definitely going to be a bit of a setback and one of those nights where you wish that O'Keefe had been out there.
Oh, exactly. But again, I think they had the depth in their roster to go to that tourney and have some success in the coming weeks. And we certainly wish O'Keefe a speedy recovery and back on the pitch as soon as possible.
Ball's going to belong to the Falcons. About 3:40 to play here in Daytona Beach. So, Mr. O'Keefe, wish you well. Sophomore out of Glanmire, Ireland, and once a student at Glanmire Community College. Definitely has left a mark on this Daytona State soccer program. Here's Sandage, the guy who scored the goal for Daytona State.
Some nice moves up front there, some shake and bake.
There's a shot, and just have not been able to square one up. Charlton has been frustrated all night long.
Yeah, it didn't look like he, you know, kind of overswung, if you will, with the right foot, just didn't get a boot on it.
I think you can tell overall, though, Ted, and you hit on it a little bit earlier, the patience, the persistence, the getting comfortable tonight. Slowly, I think maybe the pregame jitters came into play just a little bit for the home team, because part of them, they do not look like themselves. And on the other side, Eastern Florida looks like the best part of themselves.
Right. Oh, that was a heck of a strike. Back to the goal, just turned and struck it. I mean, that ball could have gone anywhere. You know, he was trying to aim for that upper left-hand corner, but wow. I'm sure D'Amico just got caught by surprise there.
Jimmy Mwanga, freshman forward out of Dublin, Ireland, with that blast. And the ball has just been exploding off the feet of the Titans here tonight.
Yeah, Coach 12-3, he's got to like that. Just a turn and strike.
So add one more to the total of the Titans. And right now it's 5-1.
Yeah. DSC being dealt with handily by the Eastern Florida team.
I think it's safe to say the calendar was circled coming into tonight.
Oh, a guarantee.
Eastern Florida.
Big yellow highlight marker taken out of the coach's pocket on that one. You know he wanted this, and obviously going to go home with a win.
I guarantee you, though, this one will now sit in the back of the minds of Daytona State, because I think we can all agree they're a better team than this, than what we have seen in the past 90 minutes, as Perez right now is on the field. And now the training staff will be waved in as he was tripped up with about 2 minutes to play. And I believe a yellow card's going to be issued here. It will be, as Hakeem Reed, that'll be his fourth yellow card of the season.
That's a stinger. When you get your ankle turned like that, he's going to shake it off, but there'll be some ice applied tonight and tomorrow. Hopefully nothing threatening future play for him.
So a tough night. O'Sullivan has been lost for Daytona State. Hopefully he is okay after tonight. And now Perez a little bit gimpy after that last series.
Yeah, he's going to hang in there. Good for him.
You know, also, sometimes you have to remind yourself, this is only a second-year program at Daytona State. So this is a program that's definitely going to continue to grow and get better as far as talent and cohesion is concerned. Not making any excuses after what has happened, but sometimes you're going to be reminded, hey, this is still a very young program trying to find its way.
Oh, definitely. And, again, on any given day, you know, especially at this caliber of play, any team can get beaten at any time. It was just Eastern Florida's night. And I'm sure we'll see some changes made in, you know, for future play between these two teams.
So final 30 seconds here at Daytona State. Not the soccer match that Falcons envisioned here coming into tonight, but certainly a night to learn and recover and regroup, because it has belonged to the Titans. Alex Alexis still looking for one. Eastern Florida attacking. And that one's not going to go into the back of the net, but for Eastern Florida, what a night. Titans come in, take care of business, and get a big 5-0 victory over Daytona State College. Miguel De Leon and Daytona State, they'll have to regroup after what just happened, and we'll have to regroup also. Ted, we're a little bit shocked, but we can take a moment, watch the players, show some sportsmanship here in the final minutes. Great crowd on hand tonight. Just a match that did not go Daytona State's way from the start.
Oh, I'd like to see what I'm seeing right here. You know, some sportsmanship being displayed. These teams know each other quite a bit already, right, from the number of times they've played each other.
The score here at Daytona State Soccer Stadium is Eastern Florida State College Titans 5 and Daytona State Falcons 1.
And certainly an impressive win for Eastern Florida.
soccer team faces the ASA College Storm at 6 p.m. Fans, if you can please.
Well, DSC Falcons gathering donations for the effort in Puerto Rico. Go to DSCFalcons.com. And a great job by the faculty staff here at Daytona State College helping out in that relief as it continues down in Puerto Rico. Great gesture by Daytona State College. Falcons and the Titans here tonight. It was 90 minutes owned by Eastern Florida State College. Take a look at Oliver 12 Trees and Eastern Florida. Some representatives of Eastern Florida were here to celebrate what was a festive night from the start for Daytona State Soccer Stadium. I also want to remind you, Daytona State homecoming kicks off next week with women's volleyball versus Eastern Florida at 7 o'clock. That's live on WDSC-TV. Women's volleyball having an awesome season, a 19-3 record, and ranked number 14 in the nation. Eastern Florida comes calling next week. Be sure and join us
at
that time.
A relatively new program, and they're doing a heck of a job over there.
Well, tough night for Daytona State, but the Falcons will certainly be back as they fall tonight 5-1, the final score to Eastern Florida. For Ted Sofianos and our entire crew here at Daytona State College, I'm Drew Felios saying so long and have a great week. We'll see you next time.